The Michelangelo Painting Truck Series with Noble Motorsports is live tonight from Viva Las Vegas. Last night we saw an awesome race here in the Cup Series. It's the last night. Last night to party it out. So who's going to come home with the checkered flag from Las Vegas tonight? Andy, we'll find that out a little bit later on. I'm down here, like I just mentioned, Andy Kessler, Ben Kilcrease, Sam Taylor's producing. We're down here in the pre-race show, going to get everybody ready for a fantastic race tonight in Las Vegas. Andy, did you party too hard last night?
A little bit, Ben. Feeling a little ill today, but I made it. I made it back to the Speedway, and hopefully one more night after this race tonight. We got one more night, so hopefully I can survive and we'll have an episode of the that movie there, if you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, I know exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah, I forgot the name. You know, somewhere where those guys, I forget the name of it, Hangover, that's it.
Okay, there you go.
When you said took Mike Tyson's tiger or whatever, so hopefully we don't have an episode like that for tonight, but yeah, we're in for some great racing here in Vegas. We saw a great race last night, caution-free, big to-do, and these guys really showed up to hammer it down, and we saw Chad Simpson just, I don't know, annihilate the field.
Yeah, he absolutely walked away with it. I don't even think he looked in his mirror after taking the green flag, except for maybe coming off pit road to see if anybody was going to run him over. Chad Simpson had the car to beat last night. We're going to see who's going to have the truck to beat tonight, though, when we get it crunk up here in about 10 or so minutes.
Yeah, we are, Ben. And, I mean, he led all but one lap, so the guy's doing something right, I guess. But let's take a look at the results from last week for the Michelangelo's Painting Truck Series. Of course, last week we were at Chicagoland there, and Dave gave a heck of a race there and led 46 of those laps and came out with the big win with Michelin and Chad Osborne and Philip Willis and Dylan Jones there rounding out the top five.
Washington didn't put on a clinic. Can't forget Goodwin, Kramer, Blackman, Robertson. Wayne Finley did a good job coming in the top 10. Chicagoland, it was a good race last weekend as well.
I'm sorry, Ben. I guess Chicago on the brain, it was Phoenix, remember?
Oh, yeah, Phoenix. Oh, dear.
It almost screwed everything up right there.
Yeah, we were thinking that was a few weeks ago they were at. Phoenix was a good race.
It was. Either way, I mean, the trucks were good at Chicago, and they were awesome at Phoenix last week. And, yeah, like you said, Dave Washington really put on a clink and led a ton of laps and showed these guys how to do it on a short track.
Oh, yeah, another guy we got to get some credit, or got to get a bunch of guys credit, Matt Hoos. He was up there running in the top 10, and then something messed up. And then T.J. Graves was doing a real good job. He got caught up in a crash. A bunch of good drivers last week up there in the top 10 had a real good truck, just got caught up in a crash. Brian Terry was one of them running good, got caught up in a late race incident. So we'll have to see if some of those guys can turn their luck back around tonight here from Las Vegas.
Yeah, it's been a tough season. We've talked about all three series for Matt Hoos this year. Last season it was kind of like Philip Willis. You know, the guy just couldn't, no matter where he was on the track, in the front, the back, or wherever, he always seemed to find the cars like he had a magnet to him or something, and he always found that wall in an unfortunate season last year. But this season he finds himself in the top of the standings there, Ben, 21 points over Dylan Jones here with only four races left. That's a pretty sizable lead there, as long as, you know, nothing major happens for the old Silent Thunder there.
Yeah, you and I were talking about just before we went live there. We were saying pretty much if Willis finishes within probably 3, 4, 5 spots of Dylan Jones in every race for the remainder four races, including tonight, he's pretty much got it wrapped up. Willis has got his lead out there to a substantial margin. He's doing a great job. That's what he needs to do here, just a little bit after halfway. So it's going to be hard for Jones to catch him, but you can't talk too soon because you never know. Willis can crash out lap one tonight, and Jones can go on and win the race.
That's exactly right, Ben. That's why we run the races, and that's why we watch them, because you never know what's going to happen. But I look at the speed charts right now in practice, and Philip Willis is fourth on the chart. So right there with Rodney Kramer and T.J. Graves for second, third, too. So real tight field there at the top of the standings, only about a tenth separate the top 10. So these guys really can get it done here at Vegas, and I'm excited to see this go on. But let's talk a little bit about the track, Ben. And we're looking at a mile and a half, pretty similar to, I don't know, every mile and a half, except the fact this one actually kind of, it's sort of like reminds me of Chicago, where you're always turning the wheel left. You're never fully straight, whether it's on the front stretch or the back stretch. Backstretch maybe a little bit, but that front stretch is really curved, and it's real unique, and it's only got 20 degrees of banking here, a little bit less than like a Charlotte or whatever. Plus, like we talked about last night, the track's worn out and tires are huge.
Oh yeah, tires are going to be a huge thing tonight. And another thing that is unique about this track, if you're on the track itself and going down the back straightaway, it looks like, I mean, a second and you're almost down it. Here at Las Vegas, this track has long sweeping turns, so you've got to be able to get to the corners good, and exit of the corners is really going to be a big thing tonight. If you cannot get off the corners, then you're not going to be probably up there in the top 10. You're going to be in the back of the pack.
Yeah, it's everywhere but the back straightaway is straight, so they only got that small little margin of straightaway, and then everything else is curved. You pick up a ton of speed when you get into two and head to, or get into three. And when you come off of two, I mean, you're a ton of speed as you head into one, and turn two can prove to be a touchy corner there with trucks getting loose there. They tend to want to feel they can push it more, and then when they do, they end up getting a little sideways there. So that's one unique thing about Vegas, and of course we love coming here, and always remember what happens here stays here, right?
Yeah, I think we learned that lesson last night when you guys were out partying. I was watching some Netflix back at the hotel.
Yeah, and then I said a little too much, and the wife got mad. But anyway, we're looking at some keys to the race here, Ben, and the long run. We saw it last night, so I wanted to throw that up for tonight. We saw it last night. Obviously.
It was a long run last
yeah,
night.
Yeah, well, I'm saying obviously, straight through, no cautions. It's a long green flag run there, 90 laps. Tonight we only have 80 laps, a little bit shorter, and I don't think that's really going to make a difference. But if you remember last night, they were only getting about 20, 22 laps for fuel. So fuel came into play last night with Dave Washington. He ended up finishing 15th instead of in the top three, like he was running the whole race. So I put that in there, the quote unquote right strategy, because last night it did not work for him at all. He was a little disappointed, and I talked to him down in the garage area, and he wasn't too happy about it. But at the same time, he said, "Yeah, I gave it a shot, hoping there was a caution. It wasn't one, so we settled for 15th." So he's a guy I expect to see up front again tonight. Just like he was last night. So keep your eyes out for that 10 truck. And also tire management, we saw it last night. You just got to take care of your stuff because as the run gets longer, we saw some guys that were slow on the start. But, man, when those tires wore out, they were pretty quick, and they were heading back up towards the front.
Tires, a huge thing, and you mentioned it on the track facts. This place eats up tires. It's almost like putting it in a wood chipper. And putting wood in the wood chipper, it eats it up just like that. So tires are going to be a huge thing. And if we see them come down under caution, four tires definitely, two, maybe even four on the green flag pit stops.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see. We saw a lot of guys last night try to do four on the green flag stops. They lost a ton of time. They were able to catch some of it back up. But overall, you're going to see a lot of two tires and no tires. Especially if it stays green, definitely if there's a caution, that's when you want to take the chance and take all four when you got the opportunity, and you're only going to lose spots instead of seconds. So if you got a good enough car, you'll definitely end up being able to get back up to the front on a four tire green yellow flag pit stop. So I'm looking forward to it. I think we got some exciting drivers here. I'm looking at the list though, Ben. I mean, a couple guys aren't here that I'm kind of shocked about.
I haven't even gotten the full list of drivers quite yet. So I have mine out, but
we were talking about Dave Washington. I don't even see him here yet.
He might not be showing up tonight. He might have some. He might be at another local short track like he was a few weeks ago.
Well, maybe, or he was. maybe he got lost in the city,
or just stayed out partying a little bit too hard.
Yeah.
Maybe. Maybe trying to drink his 15th place. Well, I don't know. We'll find out more about that. But still, a stellar field of trucks here tonight at Las Vegas.
That sounds good. That sounds good, Ben. And right now, let's take a quick commercial here before we get set up here for the race and get the qualifying done and the gridding up. And when we come back, we'll have the full broadcast for you here on Noble TV. So we'll be back right after this.
We are back here at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. Qualifying has ended, and we're just waiting to get these trucks on the grid. Here, we're going to see who's going to walk out of here with the win tonight at Viva Las Vegas. A good qualifying effort for a bunch of these guys. We'll run you through the starting lineup here in just a moment. But before we do that, Noble Motorsports and Team Explosion TV come together to form Noble TV. Like Team Explosion TV on Facebook. Follow them on Twitter at Team Explosion TV. Check out their YouTube and check out their website, TeamExplosionTV.com. Nineteen trucks about to take the green flag, getting ready to take the green flag. I think we're going to have 20 now since one person just, no, I think it's still going to be 19. Sorry about that. Starting on the pole, A1 at Las Vegas. A1 at Watkins Glen in the Cup Series a few weeks ago. Number 74, Eric Dallariva. To his outside in the double four car, starting second, Joel Edick.
Good starting spot for the 76 truck of Brad Spiedel, and to his outside in the 60 will be Brian Neff.
Matt Hoos looking to turn his luck around, starts on the inside of row number three in the 21 to his outside, series admin number two, Mitch Lennon.
Starting seventh in the number one truck, Philip Silent Thunder Willis. And to his outside in the 92, Brian Terry.
Good qualifying run for Terry, and a good qualifying run for the 5. Norman Sidlick, he rolls off 9th. Rodney Kramer in the number 6 rolls off 10th.
TJ Graves will roll off 11th, and Kenny Baum Jr. is going to start this one 12th.
Andy Carpenter, 96, he's 13th, 14th, Joseph Goodwin.
Roy Carpenter starts on the inside of row number 8, and to his outside on the 43 truck will be Wayne Finley.
Christopher Sercoy, 02, put him 17th on the starting lineup. William Roberts, 86, starts 18th.
Starting 19th in the 25 will be Doug Blackman, and starting shotgun on the field in the 33 truck will be Thomas Lee.
Stellar, field of trucks, getting ready to take the green flag.
There's a stellar field, Ben, and man, I'm looking forward to it. Looks like Rodney Kramer's going to start this one from the pits. Typically does that, except he didn't do that last night because he had a really good qualifying run, which I don't blame him, but ended up biting him. He didn't finish all that great yesterday, as opposed to what he wanted. So he's going to start with this one from the pitch, try to stay out of the melee early.
Have to see. That could help him in the long run, or it could hurt him if we get a long green flag run or go green the whole way. We really don't know what kind of racing to expect here from Las Vegas. At Atlanta, the season opener, we thought we were going to see single file. Everybody gets spread out. Andy, the top 10 were side by side and tail nose. These trucks are just so unpredictable.
They are unpredictable, and they punch a big hole in the air, Ben. So they end up able to draft on these mile-and-a-half tracks, which is quite interesting for these guys, and makes for a different style of racing than the Cup or the Nationwide cars, but it never lacks excitement, I'll tell you that, no matter where they go.
Lights are off on the iRacing.com Ford Mustang pace car. We are going to go green this time. 80 laps are on the board. Eric Dallarive qualifies on the pole. Joel Edick, those two drivers make up the front pace car, getting ready to pull down on the pit road. Who's going to party hard tonight in Viva Las Vegas? Clean start. Everybody trying to get single file. Andy trying to get in a rhythm early in the going here, and trying to just ride it out for the first 50 or so laps.
Yeah, we talked about it last night. One of the keys to the race, I want to put in tonight, but I don't want to just keep putting the same stuff in there, Ben, but it was a middle lane, and we talked to a lot of drivers after the race, and they said the middle lane was the way to go. Even on the beginning, you saw some guys move up a little higher as the run went on because the tires searching for that grip. But, yeah, as I'm looking right now, single file, they're all riding pretty much that middle lane.
Got a few drivers trying to test the waters on the low side. That one driver, Eric Dallarive, and here comes Joel Edick coming outside side by side to the lead and down the back stretch.
Joel Edick, we saw good things out of him. Rookie to this series, had a great race last week at Phoenix. Led some laps. He started from the pole, I believe, if I remember correctly there, Ben. But, he saw some good things out of this rookie here as he's now lead. Just led that lap now here in Vegas.
And lap number 3 to Edick. Here comes Brad Spiedel. He's looking to work on the high side of Eric Dallarive. Look at Brian Neff. He's trying to stick his nose back in there. And Lennon now looking to the inside of Neff. So here we go. Top 5 already tail to nose side by side.
Yeah, I definitely see that middle to high group really the way to be right now. And I don't know why Eric Dallarive is not going up there. Maybe he's just not comfortable at this present moment. But he's definitely surrendered in some positions, two already, and perhaps about to be number 3.
We squeezed up right in front of Neff. Here comes Dallarive to the high side, or to the middle group, I should say. He's almost in the wall down the back stretch. Look out, he's a little bit wobbly. Here comes Brian Neff sticking the nose to his outside. Phillip Willis eating up the rear end of Matt Hoos. That's a battle for 6 behind all the melee in front of him.
It is. Great run so far from Matt Hoos to really stick his nose up here. Be 6th place right now. Was able to catch these top 5 as they were starting to race side by side. So good move for him. Hopefully he can keep it out of trouble. And so far so good for the 21 truck.
Good racing here in the early going at Las Vegas. And Andy, I think we're starting to see it. You mentioned it just before we went green, the draft being a huge part of tonight.
The draft is a huge part. Like I said a few laps ago, man, these trucks have such a high roof, a big spoiler on the back. They really punch a huge hole. So the suck-up ratio to the back of these trucks from the guy behind is huge. And that's why we tend to see great races at the plate tracks from the trucks also.
Look out. We were going to go three wide back here in the back, a little bit further back between Malin and Hoos and Neff there. Neff thought better of it. Well, those four guys have been battling top three. Eddix, Fidel, and Dalariva, they've pulled away just a little bit, about a five or six truck length.
Yeah, as they're pulling away and those other guys are battling.
Oh, big crash! Brian Neff. Hard into the outside wall there. It looked like he and Philip Willis get together to the trial when Neff overcorrects and gets nailed by the 05 of Norman Sidley. Oh, man. Ouch.
Just what Rodney Kramer, or Rodney Kramer, just what Brian Neff did not want early in the going here. He's had some rough times and bad luck, as we were talking about Matt Hoos the same, but unfortunate here, man. This is way too early. You want to see this happen to some of these guys.
Yeah, I wonder if Philip Willis wasn't part of that. He got into Neff, or Neff got into him. Either way, Willis didn't make contact with Neff, so you got to wonder if his truck might be knocked out of line or if it has a tire rub after that, and he is your points leader. So it could get a little bit hairy for him, but second place, Dylan Jones, he's not even here.
Yeah, you know, the person who benefited Ben right here is Rodney Kramer. He started from the pits, and he got his early caution, so now he's going to be right up with these guys. He's still going to be in the back, but at least he's going to have some racing room, so he was able to dodge the first melee here.
Trucks are coming down pit road, just about every truck on the track. I think everybody's coming down wanting some fresh Goodyear rubber. We want to apologize real quick for the small little hiccup. And we'll get you an update after everybody gets off pit road, who did what, where, and who came out where. Bunch of two tires. And Brad Spidell taking only four tires. Excuse me, taking four tires. Not only four tires, taking four
tires.
I thought
he was taking six there, Ben. Put a couple of spares in the
trunk. He's going to fall back quite a bit. Maybe even out of the top ten. Not sure. I have to wait until we get a scoring update.
Like I said in the pre-race, Ben, under caution is going to be the time to take him. You're going to lose spots instead of seconds. That's exactly what happened for Spidell right there. Looks like he's still going to be, you know, pretty decent here, maybe 10th or 11th, it looks like, as things start to reshape here. But, yeah, he's going to have the fresh tires. So now this is going to, if these guys go green and get a green flag stop, it's going to put him at advantage to take just two right sides. So not a bad call at all, and we talked about it in the pre-race. And this would be the time to take four if you're going to do it at all.
Phil getting ready to come across the checkered here, or across the line, I should say. Let's go ahead and run them through how the order sits now. 44 still in the lead. That's Joel Eddick. Mitch Lennon is second. Eric Dalariva third. Matt Hoos fourth. Brian Perry, good run for him. He's up to the top five.
Yeah, TJ Graves is right there with him in sixth. Brad Spidell, like I said, he only lost a few spots. He's there in seventh. Kenny Baum Jr. there sits in eighth. And Philip Willis ninth, with Thomas Lee rounding out the top ten.
Doug Blackman, Andy Carpenter, Roy Carpenter, Wayne Finley, Christopher Sirkoy, that's the top 15. Joseph Goodwin, Rodney Kramer, William Roberts, Norman Sidlick, and Brian Neff round out the rest of the field. So, who's going to be better on two tires, or who's going to be worse?
It really loosens up the truck when you just throw right sides on there, so maybe these guys are battling tight conditions, and that two tires might actually help some of these front runners. But let's watch the 76 truck there restart in 70. He's the first one out there with four tires, so let's see how the four tires compare to the two as we get going restart here.
truck I'm going to be watching on this restart, 21, Matt Hoos. He's made it 10 laps so far. He might have a good run going here.
So far, so good for him. Plenty to go, though, as you know, we got 70 more laps to do it here. As, they're taking a green flag right now, so we'll let it get started. Taking the restart. Great restart for these guys here. Ben is Joel Edick able to pull away from Eric Dallarriva, but let's keep an eye on that 76 truck and Matt Hoos like you were talking about.
Clean restart as we go back in the corner number 3. Look at that, Dallarriva. He gets way out of shape on the bottom. Hoos almost got into him, and everybody sideways. TJ Graves sideways. Can he save it? He's able to. Wow.
That's those two tires making everything loose there. TJ Graves almost lost it there, and he finds himself dropping way back right now into the clutches of some of these other guys here in 10th, 11th place now.
Graves had that thing pointed at the inside wall. He had it pointed at the outside wall, at the inside wall again, and finally he got it straight back up. Battle for the lead. Lennon going for it on the bottom. Is he going to let it? Is he going to make it work? Side by side, Edick is able to get the run off. He's on the high side up there in the 44. That's Lennon and two on the inside. While those two are battling, a huge gap of air behind them. Matt Hoos says, yeah, I'll get on your rear bumper while you're side by side. Maybe make it 3 wide to the back stretch.
As these guys run side by side, it's going to start bringing Eric Dallarriva. Kenny Baum Jr. is now up to 5th place. He's going to bring all these guys up into the mix here for the lead. And
look out, couple in the back. Car on the wall, that's, can't get a number, Thomas Lee. No caution.
He's able to keep control of that, Ben, but unfortunate there. Looks like he just got a little bit loose there in turns 3 and 4.
TJ Graves, slow down the front stretch. Caution out, we've got more trouble. Brad Spydale turned around backwards. Heading out of the tri-oval, he and it looks like Ryan Perry, looks like Spydale just came up and wasn't expecting. I'm going to maybe try and put the slide job on Terry. Ooh, hard hit on the driver's side for Spydale. And Andy, we talked about it. Spydale was going to have the truck to beat right there. He was on four fresh tires. Bad luck for him, but there was a bunch of excitement here in those opening laps after that restart.
Yeah, it was. We definitely saw the strategies playing to effect here with these guys and with their tires and what they're going to do. And, man, a tough break there for Spydell. Definitely not what he wanted. He took a vicious lick there into that.
So we are under caution second time tonight. Gotta give a big shout out to our producer Sam Taylor, all the way over there in the UK, staying up. It's whisper.
It's really early.
1-2. Yeah, 1 or 2 in the morning over there. 1 o'clock. So give him a round of applause for staying up with us. Matt Weisbrot not able to make it tonight, but if he is tuning in, Matt, hello. Hope you're enjoying the race. Got some takers down on pit road. Brian Terry, Thomas Lee, Joseph Goodwin, William Roberts, Rodney Kramer, Graves, Sequoy, and Spydell. A bunch of those guys just had a few little minor run-ins there. And Graves, though, I think Graves missed his pit road. Pit stop. No, he's coming in.
He's coming in. But, yeah, it looks like the guys from about 9th on back came in on this chance here. They only had about 7 laps on these tires and fuel, and maybe they're going to take their chance to get their 4 tires now, make some more adjustments, and try to get these, take advantage of having this caution.
All right, so we're going to get everything all sorted up here, and my producer just whispered it to me that, hey, Mitch Lennon got the lead right there when the caution was out, so Lennon's in front of Edick here. Matt Hoos third. I think this has been the best Hoos has ran this whole season. This early in the race, he's usually already involved in a crash or having technical difficulties or something. Not to pick at you, Matt, but, man, you 50-50. Matt's trying to get that luck turned around tonight.
He is trying to get that luck turned around. I think we got a driver here, Ben, hooked up on the radio. I think it's the 15 of TJ Graves. TJ, you there?
Yes, I am.
How's it going? A little bit of a rough start there after that pit stop for you. Got a little sideways on that turn four. Just battling a little bit of loose there, or something breaking that thing?
No, I saw the inside lane check up, and I kicked it a little too hard and knocked sideways on me. I saved it, though, so we're going to be coming to the front on four fresh tires. I know it's a shocker with me, but...
Well, we talked about it in the pre-race show, that four tires and a caution pit stop would definitely be the way to go. You lose spots instead of seconds, and we know that to come into play a lot in these races. So good luck to you. We'll let you get back up there and battle this out there, and hopefully see you up front.
Thank you.
Hey, TJ, before we let you go.
Yes.
What's the... what teachers you got watching tonight?
That's unidentified as of currently. They said they would think about watching it, so I'm not going to announce anything yet.
Gotcha. All right, TJ, we'll let you get back to work. Get that thing up there in the top three for us.
Sounds good. I'll represent TSTV and Race Reporter logo that I just put on this truck earlier today.
Sounds great. TJ Graves, driver of the number 15, doing a great job in the early going. As Andy unplugs his microphone.
It's time to get these trucks wound back up there again, Ben, and maybe we'll have another big long stint here at Green Flag Run in the middle of the race here as they're getting ready to complete 18 of the 80 laps here.
Getting ready to crank these things back up. Lights are off on the iRacing.com Ford Mustang pace car.
These guys coming around to the green, Ben. Let's get it done here. 19 will be complete when they hit the green, so that's going to leave us with 61 laps to go. Tons of time left. A couple more pit stops for these guys, and like we just talked to TJ Graves, let's see how the four tires work for him, because it didn't work out very well for Spidell there.
Have to wait and see. Graves finds himself 12th after that round of pit stops. Lennon, Edick, Coos, Dollariva Bomb, top five as we head down the back stretch, getting ready to crank them back up.
Might have to call Kenny Baum Jr. here, Silent Thunders. He runs just inside of him here on the restart in fifth place. But Kenny Baum Jr. been quiet all race long, and now here he is, top five.
Kenny Baum Jr. really wants a win here in Noble. He almost had one a few weeks ago in the Cup Series at Watkins Glen. He wants to get a good finish here. He wants to get a win. A bunch of these guys want a win. They're hungry for a win. One of those guys, Matt Hoos. He's really turned his luck around so far. Pace car getting ready to pull down on the pit road. Michelin, and for the first time tonight, leads them back to the green flag. There it is. We're racing.
Great jump for Mitch Lennon there, and bringing Matt Hoos with him. Matt Hoos is looking inside of Joel Edick, heading into turn number one with Eric Dollariva.
Lennon took no time getting up to speed. Three wide behind him. TJ Graves up on the high side. And it was Thomas Lee in the middle. Sequoy on the very low side. They get it sorted out to the backstretch.
Cutting it close there. Three wide coming to the first turn on the restart. These guys need to settle down a little bit here and get sorted out. Get single file and lock some laps here.
60 laps to go. Matt Hoos up to second.
To see that draft come into play there. It looks like Joel Edick had to actually let off there heading into turn number one because he had such a good run on Matt Hoos there and just didn't want to dive it in there. Didn't think he was going to be able to make it stick there. I also want to give a big shout out. He's up there in seventh right now. Andy Carpenter, staying out of trouble. He finds himself in the top 10.
Carpenter doing a good job right behind him. You have Doug Blackman, Roy Carpenter, and Joel Goodwin rounding out the top 10. So a good run for a bunch of these guys tonight. Oh, yeah, Palm almost gets the bumper from Willis.
Yeah, I was just going to say, Blackman finished 8th last week, too, so top 10 last week at Phoenix, so he's looking to match that up again this week.
Eric Galarriba got all sorts of sideways off corner number 2, and that's holding those guys up as they try and battle side by side. Here comes Philip Willis to the inside of Kenny Baum Jr. That is for 5th. And now Willis, looking to the inside of Eric Galarriba. That's for 4th.
That trap and that run really gave Philip Willis the advantage there. And now Kenny Baum's looking to the inside of Eric Galarriba, trying to take that spot away from him. Great racing here for 5th place.
While that battle's going on for 4th and 5th, Matt Hoos goes to the lead. He gets around Mitch Lennon. Now Joel Eddick trying to get around. Look out, Lennon pitches Eddick way down low. They almost rubbed doors there.
Give him a little taste of welcome to Noble Motorsport there from the one of the series veterans there with Mitch Lennon. But great racing by those guys. It shows the patience and the driving ability of the 44 there to not feel rattled when he's got a guy like that staring down on the outside of him.
Every time we say Mitch Lennon here in any broadcast, I remember a few broadcasts ago, I can't remember where it was at or even what series, but Andy, you were interviewing him, and he still had his headphones in after getting out of the truck, and his spotter and street chief were still talking, and you asked him a question, he said, yep.
I would say that would have to be the most riveting interview I've ever had today here at Noble.
Oh, you gotta love Lennon, though. He knows how to steer a truck around the track. And he's showing it right now, working that high side. He gets back out ahead of Joel Eddick, and look at Philip Willis. Willis now looking to the inside of Eddick through 3 and 4.
Philip Willis slowly but surely just creeping his way up, taking one truck at a time, and now he's trying to work on Joel Eddick, trying to get that third spot here as they head down the front stretch.
We don't call him Silent Thunder for no reason. Look at him using double negatives. Boy, howdy, it's been a long week here in Las Vegas.
Yeah, oops.
Lennon trying to use that draft to his advantage down the back straightaway. He's starting to close that gap on Matt Hoos, but got to give it to Hoos. He's up there leading this thing. Don't want to jinx him or anything, but he's looking to turn that bad luck streak around tonight. I know I've said that quite a few times, but maybe he can. I'd love to see Hoos get a top 3 after all the bad luck he's had lately.
He's going to be a tough customer to pass for that top spot there, too. I don't care if you're Mitch Lennon or Kenny Baum Jr., Andy Carty. Whoa!
Oh, look out!
There.
Kenny Lennon in the wall. Look out! Oh, he collects Andy Carpenter. A hard hit and a vicious crash. Look out. More trucks still coming in and a vicious crash in corner number 3.
Man, that was unfortunate. It looked like Joel Eddick and, first of all, it looked like that Mitch Lennon got a little bit loose there. He was side by side with Joel Eddick. And they touch, and Eddick went way down trying to avoid it. And Mitch just, it looked like overcorrected, and found himself spinning out there and collecting Andy Carpenter.
Lennon actually bounced it off the wall in 2. Eddick jerked it down to avoid him. That's why he saw Eddick go way down to the bottom, and Lennon just was not able to get it back straight. I thought he was going to be able to save it there for a little bit, and finally, like you said, Andy overcorrected one last time and collected Andy Carpenter. And Carpenter, I think, got the worst out of that when he smacked that inside wall.
Yeah, it's tough. You're down there trying to stay out of everyone's way in this on a wreck, and then there's nowhere for you to go, and you, tough break. Somebody just comes down and tags you. So tough break for Andy Carpenter. Hopefully he can get it beat out a little bit here, and we'll find him up there still able to finish this race out.
Leaders down pit road, T.J. Graves stays out. Does he come in? Or is his truck better on older tires?
I don't know if he wants to just lead a lap or what he's doing out there, but maybe he's just going to give it a whirl here. He's, I think he's probably only got about 6 laps on those tires there, Ben, because that last caution was around lap 17 or 18 when he came in, so by the time these guys got going, he's got 4 fresh ones.
Andy is at the back of the pack, not really racing too hard, so this could be a good strategy for TJ. And Andy, if you recall, in the OIL race, my car, back at Chicagoland, my car was actually better on older tires, so that could be the same scenario for Graves. We'll just have to wait and see if he comes down pit road this time or if he stays out. But if he stays out, it's going to be fun to watch. Joseph Goodwin comes out second. So, we'll see what the deal's gonna be right here. Alright, so, and
mark
that
down. Keep an eye on that 15 truck there.
Yeah, mark that down as a third caution of the night.
Yeah, I believe that's a fourth caution we've had here tonight, Ben. We had one fairly early one day. Yeah, I think there's fourth. Three. Sorry. My horrible math skills here, Ben.
So we're all confused. TJ Graves coasting, shutting it off. He's saving fuel. Here, Andy, fuel could become an issue. I was talking to the guys a little bit earlier. They said... they could get about 40 or so laps in, if I'm not mistaken. Don't hold me to that. But these trucks able to get a whole lot more crammed in, and a whole lot they're able to. What's the word I'm looking for?
Yeah, run a lot more.
Yeah, yeah, there you go.
Because last night they were only getting about 22, and I think the most we saw was 25 there at the end by the winner, Chad Simpson. So. Yeah, these guys definitely get a lot better fuel mileage than those cup cars can.
DJ Graves looks like he's going to stay out. Ooh, this is going to get fun. Joseph Goodwin, also good pit stop for him. He's up the second. While we're at it, we'll go ahead and run you through the whole field. Phillip Willis is third. Joel Edick, fourth. Matt Hoos came in with the lead. He comes out fifth.
Eric Dallarivo's been running up in that top five, top ten all night. Finds himself sixth right now. Kenny Mom Jr. lost a couple spots there on that pit stop there, and he finds himself seventh, eighth. Doug Blackman. Ninth is Christopher Shakoy, and Roy Carpenter now finds himself in the top ten.
Rodney Kramer, Mike Bear, 11th. Wayne Finley, 12th. William Roberts, 13th. 14th is Norman Sidlick. And Brian Terry back in 15th.
16th right now is Thomas Lee. And it looks like Brad Spidell will be the last car on the lead, or last truck, I should say, on the lead lap here in 17th. Just got the wave around. Of course, Andy Carpenter is in 18th. Mitch Lennon, 19th, a couple laps down. And Brian Neff, who was called at quits earlier ago, finds himself at 20th.
Easing up on halfway here at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. If you're missing that so-familiar voice of Zane Lovett, don't worry. He'll be back next week. He just had to work a little. We got it now. We got to hope he doesn't watch the broadcast. He'll be back next week. He just had to work a little bit later into the night here Monday and Tuesday.
I'm only kidding. Zane's a good man, and we definitely miss him. It's not the same without the three of us up here doing this, but things happen. Real life happens, and these guys are doing it, and that's why we have Sam here tonight, and he's doing a heck of a job out there.
Another thing with Zane during these winter months, his beard actually keeps warm up here in the booth. So.
Yeah, it's definitely getting long enough that we can all share it as a blanket.
Oh, Zane, let down your beard. What's that? That's Rapunzel. Light pace cars down pit road. TJ Graves fires. We're back racing in Las Vegas.
That's my daughter's favorite movie right there, so she'll be all about that. Yeah, TJ Graves didn't waste any time. Now, Phil Wills on the inside of Joseph Goodwin trying to take that second spot. And Matt Hoos and Joel Edeker there side by side. Battling.
Goodwin's going to hold up these guys just a tad to the back straightaway. Look at Edick. He's looking low. No. Bomb. Looking to the very inside. They almost go three wide. Edick gets a little bit sideways. He's falling back. Here comes Phillip Willis, looking for the lead off four.
I don't think Joel Edick was ready for Kenny Bomb there to make it three wide there. Got a little spooked, I think, when his spotter came on inside. But, so he got a little bit loose there. Lost a couple more positions. Finds himself back in eighth right now.
Look at Hoos. He got a heck of a run through one and two. Just wasn't able to come all the way out with it like he wanted to because Graves was there. Graves battling side by side with Hoos. That is for second.
That's a great battle. Philip Willis now in the lead, but TJ Graves stayed out with those four tires. He's got some track position. We'll see if he can hang on to a top five spot here, if he's actually going to lose a ton of spots here on this green flag run here.
Woohoo! Graves almost gets into the back of Hoos. That was close. Look at Kenny Baum Jr. A big gaggle of trunks back here as they were trying to get around Joseph Goodwin. Doug Blackman's back there as well. Eric Dallariva and Joe Eddick all in that pickle wide.
Yeah, we got Indy Carper back on the track there. Up top high, these guys got to dodge him out here. Doesn't look like it's going to be an issue this time around here, but wounded truck out there, just trying to lock some laps and get as many points as possible can.
Bomb to third. He gets by TJ Graves. The no tires not looking to be too good for Graves here tonight. As Eric Dallariva looking to get back around him, and Joel Eddick's going to be right behind the 74.
Yeah, I'll give TJ Graves a lot of credit there. For the last 2 weeks, he's just been trying some crazy strategy, trying to put himself up front, and give him a lot of credit for trying that stuff rather than being conventional. He's really trying to put himself in a position to get a win here, but plenty of time here. Going to have to stop again, so we'll see what happens as this run gets longer here.
TJ's making it fun for us. Matt Hoos on the rear bumper of Philip Pulis. Go ahead and add K-Bomb in that mix as well. Top three, tell to know.
Great battle. And then you got a little pack of trucks there in the back with Dallariva, Joel Eddick, and TJ Graves and Blackman there right behind these guys. Just waiting for one of them to slip up and find themselves up here now in the top three.
Good racing here. And there, whoa, Graves gets it sideways on the right stretch. But good racing so far here at Las Vegas. Bunch of tail-to-nose, side-by-side action.
I think TJ was trying to avoid the wall there. Looks like he's going to hit the wall coming off of turn number two and really turn that thing to the left to avoid it.
We got real close up there. And here tonight, Andy, what I was about to mention, unlike last night in the Cup Series, the leaders not really been able to pull too far away. They've been able, the second place has been able to really stay right on the leader's rear bumper.
Yeah, and that's a draft, especially with these trucks that we were talking about. These guys, as long as they stay in line, they can really keep the pace up and keep able to stay with each other. So it's definitely working out to all their favor here. Of course, you don't want to be that leader and be the sitting duck out there, but so far so good for Philip Willis as he's able to lead some laps here and push his points lead out for the truck series up even more.
Look out, battle for third. It almost went three wide right there. Dallariva inside of Baum. Baum's on the high side, 45. Dallariva low, 74. It's going to get tight. Hoos gets a little bit out of shape. Good close racing here from second to fourth. Second to fifth, excuse me.
Yeah, great battle between these guys here. Kenny Baum on the outside there. He's got that outside line that he prefers. And no, Eric Dallariva likes that bottom line. So right now these guys just battle it out with Joel Eddick right on the bumper.
Dallariva really drove it in hard and one and two pushed up the track. Almost got into K. Baum. He's doing it here as well. Got to keep that thing on the low side if you're going to race down there. Back up for the lead, though. Hoos is caught up to the rear bumper of Philip Willis yet again while these guys have been duking it out back here for third.
They have Philip Willis just holding his line, holding his momentum. I think Matt Hoos right now is just content to ride behind him, Ben. Just lock some laps here. We've mentioned it numerous of times, his bad luck he's had this season. So right now, halfway through this race, he's finding himself second place. I don't think he wants to force any issue now and wait till the end.
I think Hoos would get down on his knees and cry if he actually finished a race. I don't even think he's finished a race on the lead lap in any of the televised series so far this year, and that's unbelievable. He's a great driver, just in the wrong place at the wrong time in a bunch of the incidents.
Yeah, and I mentioned that earlier too about Philip Lewis, that being his season last year, just couldn't get out of the way. So, yeah, it's one of the things that goes in cycles, and sometimes you just hope that you never get into that cycle. But when it does, you just got to make the best of it and make these finishes like this, or these runs like this, make them count when you can.
Brad Spiedel, that's the slow truck the leaders are going by now. Kenny Baum Jr. got passed by Eric Dalariva. Now he's getting worked on by Joel Eddick. That gets close.
Little three-wide action with the lap car and Spiedel there, but good to see Spiedel still out there trying to lock some laps, the same as Andy Carpenter, just trying to get as many points as possible. As we said it, man, after tonight, there's only three more races left this season.
Andy, I want you to take a look here. The whole top five now are tail to nose and side by side, so it really didn't take these guys too long to get caught up. Here comes Eric Dalariva. He's looking for second on the outside of Matt Hoos. He may go for the lead in 3 and 4.
Huge run he got there coming off of turn number two. And if Phil Willis wasn't there to block him, I think he might be clocking a new leader right now in the 74 truck.
Going to get tight for the lead down the front straight away. Hoos and Willis are side by side with Dalariva on their rear bumper. Baum trying to get fourth away from Joel Eddick. Baum's up on the high side. Here comes Matt Hoos. He drives it down in there real deep. Hoos going to pull a slide job on Willis. Eric Dalariva looking low. Three wide for the lead in Las Vegas heading into three.
What a battle then we got here. Three wide and three wide behind him. Blackman's looking to make this, but right now Hoos able to pull out to the lead, but Philip Lewis behind him, and Eric
Dalariva
now
going to
fall back in third.
Bump Hoos to the lead for the time being. Things settled down just a little bit. Now we're going to go 2x2 again. Willis looking low. Hoos on the high side. Dalariva back in third. He's trying to make the high side work as well.
I give these guys a lot of credit, Ben, to be that close and that side-by-side and making this thing work like this. Great piece of driving by all six of these guys right now. It's Kenny Baum trying to get fourth away from Joel Eddick there in turns 3 and 4.
Wow, what a race we've got going on here at Las Vegas. Willis gets a good run off of four. Does he use his advantage down the front straightaway? He looks inside of Hoos. Is he going to have enough in 1 and 2 to slide up in front of him and pull a slide job? Not
going to happen that time, though. Eric Dalariva finds himself on the outside of the one truck. Phil Willis moving down here in the backstretch, and now Joel Eddick looking to the outside of Phil Willis here, attempting to turn 3.
Almost reminding me of a Bristol race, Andy. You want to be on that bottom line when you're just racing by yourself or maybe just riding, but once you get some guys up on the high side and you're down there on the bottom, then it's done. It's over for you.
Oh, it is. Almost like a freight train, and that's exactly what happened to Philip Willis here. He's going to be able to hold off third for now from Joel Eddick. And now Eric Dalariva looking to the inside of Matt Hoos heading down the back stretch trying to get the lead. And Joel Eddick side by side from Willis.
These guys are racing like it's the last lap. We still got 32 laps to go. Here comes Joel Eddick. He's looking to the high side of Eric Dalariva. That's for second.
What a great battle. We were just talking, Ben. Hopefully the green flag pits us. We should come in here in the next 10 or 15 laps here. Hopefully it keeps these guys all together like this, because this is a great battle we got going on right now.
Bump Eddick, 2 second. Andy, in the races we've seen with Joel Eddick, like you said, newcomer to the Noble League, he has done a fantastic job. A real aggressive driver. He knows where to put the truck and when to put that truck where he needs it, and now he's going for the lead down in 1 and 2.
Yeah, he had a great race in Phoenix. Found himself up in the top 5, top 10 the whole race long, but like many other guys, just found himself in the wrong place, wrong time, and caught up in a wreck there, and unfortunate poor finish for him it ended up being. But, we've seen him run up front already, and he's been doing it all night tonight, too.
Norman Sidlick. Engine expired for that truck. He's heading down pit row. Battle still for the lead.
There's Dalariva looking to the outside of Joel Eddick, trying to take that second spot, as Matt Hoos is just right in front of these guys, and now Phil Willis looking to the outside of Joel Eddick, too. Kind of the same thing we just saw happen to Phil Willis there a second ago. Once these guys get to their outside and ends up losing a couple spots.
Give a hand to Doug Blackman sitting back there in fifth. He is doing an awesome job in this race tonight.
Doing exactly what I'd be doing, man. Just sitting back, staying with that little draft pack they got going, and letting these guys battle it out. Let them beat up their trucks and just ride back here and hopefully have something for them for the end.
Two trucks just pulled up behind the line and now have officially are officially done for the night. That's Andy Carpenter, Norman Sidlick. While this battle still goes on for the lead. Five trucks, and Zane's going to like me for saying this, five trucks so close you can throw a blanket over them.
Yeah, he used that quite a bit there Sunday night. I think that's his new favorite saying, Ben. But, yeah, these guys are really, man, like I said, if I was in the middle of this draft for race car, Ben, I would already taken out all five of them. So I give these guys a lot of credit, and that's why I'm up here in the booth and not down there in these trucks.
Oh, dude, I think I probably would have taken out a few myself.
Yeah, I'd have a lot of angry fellow truckers there mad at me, but that's all right. I'd rather call a great race like this anyway because I'd be too nervous being in it.
Oh, yeah, Eddick slipped up and forward just a little bit. Willis got to the inside of him. Now down in one and two, Eddick's going to have that momentum to the high side. Meanwhile, Matt Hoos has pulled out about three or four truck lengths so far. Now that margin's starting to diminish as they get back single file.
As they get back single file, watching Kenny Baum Jr. here and Roy Carpenter. Good run for Roy sitting there seventh right now, but watching these guys just pretty much stay in single file, hoping to try to catch some air off of these front five and maybe get themselves up there in this battle. It's Eric Dellariva now looking the inside air of Blackman there in turn one and two.
Blackman's going to have that outside advantage, though, to the back straightaway. Dellariva just barely slides up behind him, other than almost put the bumper there to him for a second. Eddick all over the rear bumper of Matt Hoos. He's looking low. Does he use the traffic as a pick? Does he use it as a pick? Where's the traffic?
Looks like he backed off there and didn't want to use it as a pick and didn't want to get himself into trouble here as it looks like Hoos and all the rest of the leaders are going to go high over here on Brian Terry.
More lap traffic. Willis looking to the inside of Eddick. There's lap traffic, though. There's lap traffic. Look out. That's going to get close if Willis doesn't back off. What's going to happen here? He slides up in front of Blackman. Whoa!
That was great. Blackman gave him a little bit of room there, but now he lost the momentum and Eric Dellariva all over his back bumper. Trying to get that fourth spot away from him again.
Wow. Unbelievable racing here at Las Vegas.
Philip Willis really sticking it in there. And, man, that was, excuse my French, but ballsy to get in there like that with the lap car, Spidel down there. Man, nowhere to go. And you just hope that guy on the outside there gives you the room to beat it.
Here comes Eddick. He's got a good run off before. Hoos goes up the block the high side. Oh, you know Eddick wanted that high side, but Hoos took it away from him down the front stretch. These guys are duking it out for the lead.
As long as you can take that line, the preferred line, away from the guy behind you, you got a really good chance to stay out in front of them, you know, and hopefully the respect factor's there. You don't get turned for it, but no, great job, Matt. Who's like that bottom line, but coming off the corner, he's coming up on the high line, taking that that exit away from these guys right now. He's able to stay out front and lead these laps.
Now, when do the pit stops occur, and who does what when? We'll have to see when all that happens here. It might not happen for another 10 or so laps. We just don't know. Oh, here comes Joel Eddick looking to the inside. Yet again, he's not giving up on that inside.
No, he's not. And you know what that does too? It just puts the pressure on Matt Hoos to not mess anything up. But at the same time, by doing that, it just brings these guys behind you coming back up. And look at Kenny Baum Jr. now making himself a part of this. He hasn't been for the last few laps. Now he finds himself right behind Eric Dellariva.
Ed Baum have been saving his tires right there. He might have been. He told me last night, actually, in the West Pro Series race at Bristol, he said, hey, I'm going to have to start saving my tires because I just use them up in the first five laps. That's not good for anything.
So Bob might have actually done a bunch of practicing today and might have actually been saving his tires here in the late going. 20 to go.
Yeah, 20 to go. And that between that and that draft here, you definitely, man, you want to save that stuff, but maybe he's putting himself in that position to get that no-tire or two-tire change here on the last pit stop, especially if it goes under the green flag here. But Phillip Willis now on the outside of Joel Edick, looking for that second spot and looking for more from that hoops.
Look at this racing. This is unbelievable. The top three right there are tail, two nose, and side by side. What a race. Willis has the outside. If he would have been able to keep it down in one, he... Oh, he almost missed the bumper to Hoos. Willis had to get out of it. Here comes Joel Edick on the inside.
I think Willis was really trying to get on the inside of Matt Hoos there and just basically realized he did not have enough room and almost was a big incident there with the back bumper of Matt Hoos.
Look at this racing. Unbelievable. Wow, they've been doing that. Here comes Eric Dalariva back in the mix. So now go ahead and add four trucks to that. And if they don't get single file here in the next few laps, it's going to be about 10 trucks.
It is, man. Great battle by these guys. The top eight are only separated by a second and a half bend right now. And that's some great racing. You think you're at Martinsville or something. But these guys are here at the mile and a half of Vegas, and they're really getting it done here, similar to what we saw last night.
Through three and four, top four, they do get singled out just a little bit right there off of four. Edick has a run. Does he jump out to that outside? Not going to work that time.
Well, it's not going to work, and I think Kenny Baum and Blackman here, Doug Blackman, are really starting to catch up to these top four here. It looks like once they got single file, they were almost using each other's draft to catch up to these guys. And so far, it looks like it's working here. Closing the gap only about seven truck lengths away.
Ooh, Edick almost drove it in there a little bit too hard. He almost got into Phillip Willis down pit road. So pit stops now, Andy.
Starting to happen, Ben, and we're looking at about 15 or so laps to go here. So this will be it for fuel and tires. So the strategy is now in the hands of these crews and to see if they're going to take two, four, no tires, fuel only, what these guys are going to do. But it looks like a couple more guys, the 21 and the 44, heading down pit road now, too.
Dalariva looks to be coming as well. Baum, he kind of got trapped right there. Baum trying to make up a bunch of room.
What a move by Kenny Baum Jr. there on pit road. I think it almost looked like he was going to stay out, and then he realized last second all these guys were coming in, and, man, he just pointed it down there and slowed that truck way up.
Phillip Willis was the first truck to come down pit road. Is that an advantage to him?
It may be. Oh, Derek Dalariva made
the pit stop. He is definitely done for the night. Oh, and Joel Edick just hit him. Oh, my. Edick is now going to be done, and Eric Dalariva, they're going to be out of it. Meanwhile, Matt Hoos is in the lead.
He didn't take any tires on that stop there by Matt Hoos. I was watching his pit stop, Ben. No tires, just fuel. Fuel only, 15 to go, 14 to go this time by, and... he's looking for this win. He wants it bad.
Willis does have some fresh rubber, I do believe. So he's going to be on the move here, trying to get up there to Hoos. Willis is fifth. Now he's fourth.
Yeah, I was going to say Kenny Baum took some tires there too. So Matt Hoos right now has about a three-second advantage on Kenny Baum Jr., but with those tires, I expect these guys to at least close that gap somewhat. I don't know if they have enough time to catch them and pass them, but they should be able to close that gap here.
And let's talk about Joel Edick. He has just pulled a behind-the-wall busted radiator on that truck, and Andy, he was one of the trucks that had a chance to win tonight.
He did. And, 2 weeks in a row, Ben. 2 weeks in a row at good, three-fourths of the race were his in the top five, in the top ten, yep. Battling great with these veterans, and then a late race incident there, and that's why we run all the laps, because you never know what's going to happen at any point in a race.
just bad luck. One person that hasn't had bad luck tonight, that number 21 of Matt Hoos. But he just got caught a half. Kenny Baum Jr. caught him by half a second that lap. So the way it's going right now, Hoos might get caught.
Yeah, he might get caught. But like you said, Ben, with the draft and all that, catching him's one thing. You still got to pass the guy. So those, as long as Kenny Baum doesn't overdrive those two tires, he's got a real good chance here to catch Matt Hoos in the next few laps here. We've got about 11 to go or so.
Another half a second knocked off that time. 11 laps to go. Make it 10 and a half when we make it to the back straightaway. This is going to get good. Lap traffic in front of Hoos and Fred Spidell. Don't think he's going to be a factor to the finish of this one.
Kenny Baum really making some ground up here. It looks like he's really getting them on the entry of the corner. It looks like Matt's okay on the exit, but it looks like the entry of the corner, Kenny Baum's able to dive it in a little bit deeper than Matt Hoos.
3/10 that time. It has now become visual how close Baum has been able to make up the gap. Right behind Baum, you got Phillip Willis and Rodney Kramer. Willis just got by Kramer for the third position.
Hats off to Kramer there. Great job starting the pits there. We talked about that. Got that early caution. Was able to stand the strategy of the leaders and finds himself now in the top five.
Good strategy in the late going. Ooh, this is going to get good. Here comes Kenny Baum Jr. Less than 1 second away from Matt Hoos, and right behind Baum, you have Willis and Kramer.
Yeah, you got Willis about a second behind Kenny Baum. So the way Kenny Baum's running these lap times he's taking off, I really put him at the advantage. I don't know if Willis has enough time to catch Kenny Baum, but Kenny Baum really pulling up to that 21 truck there. Every time it's on the entry of the corner, man.
Two tires, definitely the way to go. Don't leave now. Don't get up, use the bathroom. Don't get up, pop some more popcorn. Just sit right here and watch it. 8 laps to go, and we've got a dandy here in the late running at Las Vegas. Kenny Baum Jr., can he get around Matt Hoos and win his first ever Noble Motorsports race?
You know, Matt Hoos really wants a win to kind of, I guess, make his season he's having in all three divisions a little bit better, a little bit sweeter with a victory. And he's getting caught pretty quick here now as the lead's only a half a second, Ben.
This is getting good. Baum, he's got a taste of the draft. Here comes Kenny Baum Jr. He's on the rear bumper of Matt Hoos down the backstretch. Off of corner number 4, 6 laps to go, and here comes Baum. Phillip Willis, he's catching Baum as well.
He is, Phillip Willis. These guys get, Kenny Baum's all over the back bumper now in the 21 truck of Matt Hoos. He is there battling for this lead now.
Down the back straightaway, Baum eating up the rear bumper of Matt Hoos. Phillip Willis, he's trying to close that gap as well. It's a 3-truck battle for the lead. Off of 4, Matt Hoos is going to see 5 laps to go here in Las Vegas.
And Kenny Baum's making that move on the inside here, heading down into turns number 1 and 2. The high line has been the preferred line, but Kenny Baum does have that.
Look out!
Matt Hoos is pinching him down.
They almost touch. Hoos still has the advantage on the high side. Here comes Phillip Willis.
These guys are battling out. Now you got Silent Thunder up here trying to get his win, his second win of the season, too, here in the trucks, and extend that point lead even more.
4 laps to go at Las Vegas. Hoos still clinches that outside. Does he have enough? He almost gets in the Baum down the front stretch. Baum gets sideways. 4 to go.
What a great battle. Really making that bottom line work is Kenny Baum Jr., and I think right now the only reason he's able to do that is those two tires that he took and where Matt Hoos didn't. But these guys are door-to-door, side-by-side, heading down the backstretch into turn number 3.
Hoos still has that advantage on the high side, this time by off of corner number 4. It's going to be 3 to go. They almost touch. 3 to go.
Side-by-side for this, and Phillip Willis looking to make it maybe 3 wide for the win.
bum. And Hoos, you can't slide a piece of paper between their trunks. To the back straight away. Hoos still has a slight advantage. This is a three-truck gaggle for the win. Who wants it the most?
And look who's sneaking up. I'll just point this out. Rodney Kramer is now pulled in within a second of these guys because they're battling so hard for the win as they come to the line.
This time by, popsicle sticks in the air, two laps to go at Las Vegas. Philip Willis, who gets in the bum? They got a little bit loose, heading out of the tri-oval there. Did it damage any of their trucks too much? What's going to happen to the back straightaway? Matt Hoos has had a horrible season. I'm going to go ahead and say it. Bad luck has been the definition. Bum hasn't won an Oval Motorsports truck race in a while. Philip Willis, he's your points leader. Rodney Kramer, he started from the pits. White flag, this is the final lap. Kenny Bob Jr. looking to the inside. Does he have enough? No, he slides it up. Half a track to go.
Philip Willis inside of Kenny Bob, heading into turn number three. This is going to be a great battle to the line.
Through three and four. If Matt Hoos can hold on just a little bit longer. Here we come. Matt Hoos ends the bad luck streak. Bob's going to be second. Philip Willis third at Las Vegas.
Woo-hoo! What a race. Rodney Kramer, too. Heck of a job there. Coming in fourth there. Really, man, a four-truck battle, man. What a way to finish.
Let me walk out here to the ambulance I have waiting for me. I just had a heart attack. No, I'm kidding. Oh, man. That was awesome.
Oh, yeah, it was.
Woo. I don't know what to say. We're just going to, let's just watch Matt Hoos and see what he does. We're just, I've got to catch my breath here for a second, Andy.
Hey, great one, Ben.
Matt Hoos, about to burn him down. Matt Hoos, the bad luck streak has came to an end. He is going to be one happy camper. Not only will he be a happy camper, Kenny Baum Jr., Philip Willis, Rodney Kramer, they will be too. They know they came so close to winning. They're going to be excited as well. Matt Hoos, though, story of the night. Wow! It don't get no better than that in Viva Las Vegas. Let us catch our breaths for quite a bit here. We're going to head to a quick commercial break, and we'll be right back to talk to the top three. We're back here on No Bull TV after witnessing an unbelievable race at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. I'm still out of breath. I know Andy is. I bet you all the drivers are. Andy, you've caught up with third place Philip Lewis, and I think you're going to catch up with Kenny as well. Whew, what a race, Andy.
Oh, this was a heck of a race, Ben. And, I'm heading down pit road here and trying to catch up with these two guys. I got Philip Willis here. Phil, third place finish, man, and you're going to extend this points lead you got over Dylan Jones, seeing that he wasn't here and Spidell had some issues. You did have Rodney Kramer there finish up there in fourth, but overall, man, you're just extending this points lead now with only three races to go.
Yeah, I wanted to see this thing get about two more laps. That was some fun racing up there we were having for the lead, especially coming down the last five. I took two tires on that last stop, and I said, I'm not going to sit there and not take tires during this run. I said, it's costing me two wins already. It was not happening this time, and I was catching them down. If I'd had two more laps, I think it would have been something pretty interesting.
Yeah, we were talking about that up in the booth, and Matt Hoos actually only took fuel only on that stop. That's why he was able to pull away from you guys, but you guys definitely caught him. But me and Ben were talking about up in the booth that catching the guys one thing, but actually getting by him is another thing, especially with the trucks with the big hole they punch in that air with the draft. And how much did your draft really affect your truck tonight?
It was working pretty good. Once I got a lead, it felt okay. But once, you know, you get those tires hot and greasy, you got to time your marks going into the corners, especially in 3 and 4, because you'll get them tires blistering hot, and you'll start sliding around in the trouble, as y'all probably saw the second to last lap, because I was right on Matt Hoos's bumper there.
Yeah, it was a great battle. We had talked about it just before that green flag pit stop, about hopefully this pit stop doesn't separate these guys, because, man, what a heck of a battle. They had like 7-8 guys up there battling for the lead in the closing laps. And, man, what a heck of a race. Anybody you'd like to thank for this third-place finish for you?
I want to thank Michelangelo's Painting and you guys at TSTV for putting this on. Y'all put on a heck of a show week in and week out, and you got to thank Noble Motorsports for putting this lead together. It's been a fun league all season long, and hopefully we can take this thing to the end.
I hear you, Philip. And, man, great job, third place finish, and this will be one you'll want to go back and watch, man. I'll tell you, it was something to watch, something to see. We were glad to do it, but I appreciate your time. And Kenny Baum's here standing next to me also. Kenny, second place, man. I thought you almost had that first Noble win there under your belt.
Yeah, me too, but it wasn't my night, and that's fine. I'll take second.
That was a great battle you guys had. It looked like it was some of the side draft was being used by Matt, pulling down on your side through the corners there, and he was able to stay with you on the outside there. And in the long run, it just seemed that the outside line was the preferred line, and that's ultimately what won it for him.
Yeah, at the end of the run, my car was really good on the high side, but after the pit stop and took two tires, just I didn't want to change any tires, really, because it was running perfectly fine on old tires. But I changed two and made it a little bit better, and we ran Matt down, but couldn't seal the deal.
No, you couldn't seal the deal this time, Kenny Bum, but, man, what a heck of a run. Great job by you there in that 45 truck, and anybody you'd like to thank for this one?
TeamSplosionTV.com.
Enough said right there. Ben, I think you're in victory lane with a guy who's needed a victory here at Noble for a long time. It's been a while coming for Matt Hoos, but I hear you've caught up with him, and they're having quite a celebration.
He got out of the truck, gave me a big old hug, wanted to kiss me on the cheek, but, well, he did. No, I'm kidding. Matt Hoos, you have had bad luck after bad luck after bad luck in every televised series here at Noble Motorsports. You turned it around tonight. How you feel?
Yeah, I don't know what's been up with that lately. It's just really nice to get that put behind me for at least this race today. But I tell you, Philip and Ken, man, they were giving it all they had, and I was not giving up that high line no matter what. And at that point, I apologize to Ken if I had cut him off at any time or whatever, but I was just trying to hang on for a win here because it's been a long time.
Matt, you took no tires on that last pit stop. We thought you were in trouble when Kenny and Philip and Rodney were chasing you down there. How'd you end up holding them off in those final 6-7 laps?
Well, it was a last-minute decision. Last-minute decision going into the pits there and taking no tires. But then with little advice, I decided not to, and got out there to a 2 second lead, and then I was just watching the clock and watching the mirror, and I noticed they were all catching me, and then I tried to move them back and forth a little bit to shake the draft from Ken, but that didn't help. So once they caught me, I just knew I had to stay up high, and if I would have left the high line open, I would have been in trouble.
Well, Matt, you turn the bad luck around. Maybe we'll start seeing you here, at least in the top three, from now on out, since you got that bad luck off your shoulder. You turn it around tonight. Who do you want to thank for getting you in victory lane?
Well, I guess, as a lot of other people say, I got to thank Noble Motorsport. But I tell you, I'd go a little farther with when myself, Dave, and Rick started this thing over a year ago. We just acquired some great guys and then added Mitch and Rodney to help us out with the adminning stuff. And, man, they've taken over, did a great job. And then we've got a bunch of great racers here. So just Noble in general, everybody all the way around.
It is one of the best leagues we put on a show for right here. One of the best leagues on iRacing, if not the best. Matt, we thank you for talking with us, and congratulations on the win tonight.
Yep, thank you, guys, and this better be on YouTube so I can listen to it going down the road.
we'll do our best. Matt Hoos, Andy, winner tonight here in Las Vegas. He got it turned around on the right track. Can't leave out Kenny Baum Jr., Philip Willis, or Rodney Kramer. They put on a heck of a show as well. I'm glad we do got the post-race trailer, though, right beside Victory Lane here, because I'm going to be there in just a sec. But, Andy, tell us a little bit about your feelings right now after the end of this one.
I'm telling you right now, Ben, I'm putting Vegas on the top of my – I mean, first it was Iowa. It's one of my favorite tracks to watch a race, and the product that we had was just phenomenal. We saw like two or three great races, different series on Iowa at once, and it was like, oh, my God, this is like the best place ever. And then we go down to Chicago, and we're like, oh, my God, this place is phenomenal. And then the last two nights being here, Vegas for Noble Cup and the trucks, and not that yesterday's race was bad, but – man, nobody had nothing for Chad Simpson, but we had battles throughout the whole field, and those guys put on a heck of a race. No cautions. I mean, that's just a feat upon itself. And then now tonight you come in here, you know, we only had three cautions. That's nothing. And these guys put on that whale of a show and that huge long green run at the end of the race there. They had to make a pit stop under green flag, and strategy. Exactly what talked about in the pre-race show was strategy, and we saw two different strategies here with two tires, and then we saw one with no tires, and the no tires actually ended up winning the race. The two tires caught him, but they still had to pass him, and they weren't able to get that done. So Matt Hoos finds himself in victory lane, a much-needed win for him, and you know this is going to boost the confidence. I expect big things out of him coming up here in a few weeks, in the next few weeks anyway.
Andy, we leave Las Vegas. Three more races. Philip Willis really boosted himself up in the running order tonight as far as championship points go. He got a heck of a points night tonight. Does anybody catch him? And if so, who?
Listen, the way he's running right now, especially in the trucks, he's up front every week. Qualifying, okay. You know, I think tonight he qualified, I believe it was 10th. So seventh. He started 7th tonight. So, it's okay. You know, his qualifying's okay. It's not like it's killing him and he's starting back in the 20s and having a hard time getting through the field. So he's starting relatively close to the front, so it's making his night easier. He's able to, you know, and we talk about it, as the race goes on, he just gets better and better and better. And we saw that again tonight, you know, and with a third-place finish for him. He led a bunch of laps, was able to get those bonus points there. So, man, the way he's running right now, you look at the standings, the top five, and three of the top five, two of them weren't here, and one had major issues with Brad Spiedel. So Rodney Kramer, who was 43 points behind him, finished one spot behind him, which is only going to, you know, a point there or whatever. So he's still 42 points out. And I don't know if anyone has anything to catch him unless some catastrophe happens where the guy blows up 3 weeks in a row and finishes last. But the way he's been running, how consistent he's been running, Ben, and I know I'm getting long-winded here, I just don't see it, man. He's just got to keep doing what he's doing, and he's got this thing.
Well, like you like to say every week, we're here to race, and that's what we're here for. You never know until the checkered flag drops, who's going to finish where.
We saw that in Indianapolis earlier season.
Yep, exactly, with Eric Delarue running out of gas. Sorry to bring that up, Eric, once again, but, you know, you never know. I mean, we're here to race, and that's what we're going to do. We've got three more races. All Willis has to do is make sure he's got a good motor in his truck and a good foot on the gas pedal and two good hands on the steering wheel, and I think he's pretty much got that covered. But got to have a good truck, got to have a good motor here in the final few races here in the Noble Michelangelo Painting Truck Series. But before we head off here in just a little bit, let's go ahead and run them through the whole finishing order here. Matt Hoos coming out with the lead. He led 39 laps tonight. Zero incidents as well. I thought I'd throw that in there. Kenny Baum Jr. came home second. Philip Willis was third. Rodney Kramer, fourth. William Roberts rounded out the top five. Doug Blackman was sixth. T.J. Graves, good run for him, seventh. Rory Carpenter, Joseph Goodwin, and Wayne Finley, top ten. Both are all good runs for those guys.
Yeah, that's two top tens back-to-back for Wayne Finley, so great job by him. 11th was Christopher Chicoy. 12th was Thomas Lee. Brian Terry finished 13th. Eric Dallariva, unfortunate right there, finished 14th. Ended up a lap down there that last green. He was found himself battling for the win there up into that last green flag pit stop there. So unfortunate for him. 15th was, of course, Brad Spiedel. We talked about his issues earlier. 16th was Joel Edick. Same thing with him. Another great start to the race. He led 12 laps and was up front the whole time until that one little mishap on pit road with Eric Dallariva. So unfortunate for him. 17th was Norman Sidlick. 18th was Andy Carpenter. Again, wrong place, wrong time. Mitch Lennon just kind of came down track and got him. But, and of course, Mitch Lennon finishing 19th there with the issues he had. And 20th, finishing off the night, 20th was Brian Neff in the 60 truck.
Little bit of bad breaks for those guys. One of the biggest would be Joel Edick right there on that final round of pit stops. But, Andy, like I said, before we got the green flag, on the initial start, I said, we don't know what kind of racing to expect, but we knew it would be unpredictable. And that, I guess you could consider that being the definition of unpredictable.
Oh, absolutely, Ben. And you know what I'm looking forward to is next week we head to Kentucky with these trucks, and you're talking about a track that's very, very similar, mile and a half, worn out, just like Vegas is, and that's that hot yep. Kentucky sun there. And man, I plan to expect to see next week exactly what I saw this week, and I sure hope so, man, because these guys put on a heck of a battle on a worn-out track and a slick track to be that also.
It is going to be fun. Next week at Kentucky, we only had three cautions tonight. Like you said, Andy, not too bad. They only lasted 9 laps, so not even a full 10 laps spent under caution. 8 lead changes, and that was only at the line. If they scored them around the whole track, it would probably have 20 or 25. But that's pretty much going to wrap it up for us here tonight at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. Andy, as we head out of Las Vegas into the Nationwide Thursday, did you answer the Truck Series?
The only closing statements I have for the trucks is, man, what a battle. This series is going to end before the Cup or the Nationwide Series does, but these guys are putting on a heck of a show, and so far I think maybe the best show of Noble Motorsports this season between the three series, and they're 7 races down, so 3 to go here, and Philip Willis finds himself with a huge commanding lead right now, and it's going to be, he's going to have to keep that truck pointed straight and keep it up in the top 10, and he's not going to have any worries here with 3 to go.
We'll have to see what happens in the final three races. I know Sam Taylor, it's late for you. He's ready to get on off the bed, but I know he's glad he stayed up for this one because that was a dandy of a battle, a barn burner, a slobber knocker, a boy howdy, whatever my other phrases are there.
We're in Vegas, Ben. We don't need to get into those.
Yeah. We don't need to list all of them. We could go on for. We could have a 3-hour pit stop special. But it's pretty much going to do it all for us. Remember to like Team Explosion TV on Facebook. Follow them on Twitter. Check out their YouTube page and TeamExplosionTV.com. Also, follow Team Explosion TV on Twitch. You'll get email updates every time we go live, and those are always so handy-dandy if you want to just tune into a broadcast one night when you're sitting there with the wife watching what's those weird shows, Andy, I don't even know, but the chick flick TV shows.
You know, Bachelor or something.
Yeah, something like that. Oh, well. That's going to do it for us here tonight at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. For Sam Taylor, Andy Kessler, I'm Ben Kilcrease. Have a great night, and we'll see you Thursday for the Nationwide.
Hey, Court is on TSTV for the running of the 2013 A Court Training Pace Championship Series. It's fixed setups on Monday nights in the most exciting IndyCar series of iRacing. Check us starting Monday, April 1st at 9 p.m. Eastern on TeamSplosionTV.com.